A young man holding his dying cousin in his arms begged 911 operators to help save his life. But now the caller is in jail, charged with murder. News 5's Eric Flack has this heart-wrenching story. It's the number three pick.
David Leonard and Tony Duncan are forever linked in life.
The best of friends. They grew up together.
And now in death.
They not one cousin, they was brothers. And it's sad. It's real sad.
Hello?
Yes, what is going on there?
Yes.
Tell me what's going on.
He's bleeding. My cousin's bleeding to death.
The frantic call came in Saturday night from this apartment on North Bend Road. David told the 911 operator his cousin Tony was dying and needed help.
Ask him if he was stabbed.
Asking what?
Ask him if he was stabbed.
Was he stabbed? He shook his head and said, no.
Okay.
What happened?
I asked him how he cut himself then.
How you feeling right there? He said, he don't know.
But investigators say the victim was just covering for his cousin and lifelong friend, who is now charged with the murder. The best guess is that a play fight escalated and turned violent. Tony Duncan on the floor stabbed David Leonard on the phone, trying to save his cousin's life.
So I need you to pump hard and fast in the middle of his chest there.
Okay.
Right between his nipples, okay?
Okay.
Minutes later, EMS arrived, but it was too late. And now Sharon Leonard has one son in jail, a nephew she will never see again, and a hole in her soul that will never be filled.
And I lost two people that I love. I lost both of them.
The victim's mother declined to speak on camera tonight, but told me she can forgive David Parker for what he did to her son, or allegedly did to her son, but she will never forget. She added, we love Tony dearly, and he will be missed. Reporting live from the newsroom, Eric Flack, News 5.
Eric, since the cousins were so close and the family indicates there was no malicious intent, are you hearing that the murder charge might be downgraded to something less serious?
Well, I mean, it's a question that a lot of people are asking, and I asked investigators that same thing. And what one detective told me was that the question is really up to prosecutor's office if they want to change the murder charge that's been handed down right now. But that detective added that the facts are the facts, regardless of how badly the suspect feels now about what happened.
Eric Flack reporting live tonight.